Hey, it's SGU, and welcome back to the Russ Courtnall Be a Pro series here in NHL 17. Courtnall starting his career with the Columbus Blue Jackets. They're 1-1 out of the gates, but we're looking to take on the Chicago Blackhawks here and get a win. This will be a definite test to see where we're at starting this season. If we can hold our own with the likes of Patrick Kane, Jonathan Toews, and company. And we'll have our home crowd behind us here at Nationwide Arena. As you see, we are throwing it back to some third jerseys from the past. Kind of liked this set back in the day. Columbus has had some interesting ones. I said before in this series and all of my NHL series, and I'll say it again, I'm a big jersey collector, or I have been in the past, both authentic jerseys and game-worn jerseys. And I have my favorites, and I'll be highlighting some of them that are in the game as we go right now. Not so thrilled about anything that the Chicago Blackhawks and specifically Patrick Kane are doing. He gets his third of the season and opens the scoring 1-0 Blackhawks. Okay, we win this faceoff and in the zone, looking to get the equalizer. This is out front. Nope. Out to the point. Going to put this on net. No. Still working it around. Slap shot and rebound is put in. So we do get that goal to tie it up and make it 1-1. Juicy rebound left by Crawford. And we are able to capitalize on that. You see the Blackhawks wearing the jerseys they wore in the Stadium Classic last year against my Minnesota North Stars. Thought I'd throw those in there for some fun. Oh, look at that shot. Just go wide. Crawford dove for it, even though it was going wide of the net. But look at this. Still working the puck around is Columbus. Hard shot from the point. And another rebound is put home. Columbus will take the 2-1 lead. Fire the cannon. The Blue Jackets have found the net again here in the first period. So 2-1 for the home team as Cam Atkinson gets his second goal of the night already as he scored both goals for the Blue Jackets. Now a turnover going into the Blackhawks zone. Waiting to set this up. Possibly it's Courtnall. He's going to pass it over. No, it's taken away by Courtnall. And in front he scores. A major mistake by the Blackhawks, turning over the puck right in front of Corey Crawford, and Courtnall makes him pay. It's one thing to get set up by a teammate in prime position in front of the net like that. It's another thing to be set up by an opponent, as he just kind of shoveled that one away from the net, not knowing Courtnall was right there with his stick down, and he's able to beat Crawford. Columbus has the 3-1 lead. Two goals here midway through the game separates these two teams, but here come the Blackhawks. Bobrovsky can't find that puck, and eventually it's Patrick Kane again who finds the back of the net, his second goal of the night, and he pulls Chicago to within one. What happened here? Bobrovsky almost has his teammate, his defenseman, put it in the net, but then it slides right onto the stick of Patrick Kane, who does not miss. So here come the Blackhawks, another shot on net. Bobrovsky turns that away, but they are cycling this around, and oh my, that shot caught him up high, shoulder or mask area, and there for the rebound, putting it home, and it's now 3-3. Tough luck right there for Bobrovsky, as this puck is going to carom off him high, can't find where it is, and the rebound put home. We have a brand new hockey game, 3-3. Okay, well, we had the two-goal lead. That's evaporated. Let's see if we can go ahead and get the lead back here in the third period. Jumping over the boards, but here come the Blackhawks back the other way. Trying to transition into defense now and maybe pick up his man at the point if this is cycled around. Yeah, instead, they're going to go cross the crease with the pass, and there's no defense there to stop it. We heard previously from Patrick Kane scoring two goals. This time it's Jonathan Toews getting on the board to give the Blackhawks the lead at 4-3. Watch it again. It's Kane that sets him up. He's allowed to pass that all the way from over by the boards across the crease. And look at Toews just ready to slam it home. And he does not miss. So this game ends up a 4-3 final. That is how it's going to end. We squander a two-goal lead. Blackhawks come storming back here to score the last three goals of this game, and that's a tough luck loss for Columbus. Got to learn how to close games like this out, but easier said than done against a team that has a pedigree such as the Chicago Blackhawks. They know how to finish games. They know how to come from behind. They take two of the three stars on the night, so That drops us to 1-2 on the season, but we got to regroup here. We got the Dallas Stars coming up next. We're going to go to Dallas to take them on at the American Airlines Center. Here we go. Like to get a good road performance here and bounce back after the way we lost that game against the Blackhawks. Looking for a strong start. Play a solid road game. Be responsible. Don't get buried early here because there's a lot of firepower in this Dallas Stars lineup. That shot misses wide by Courtnall. They're going to keep it in and to the point. This is worked around. Courtnall feeds his teammate, and it's in the net. He sets up Cam Atkinson as he scored two in the last game, and he's got one here to start the scoring in the first minute of the hockey game. Cam Atkinson, his fourth of the season. That comes on a pass from Courtnall. Dallas comes and ties it up in the first period. We got a 1-1 game. Now starting the second period, opening faceoff of that period. And let's try to gain possession of the puck. We do just that. Coming on into the offensive zone. Nice little move there. Puts it on net. And shoveling it home is Courtnall. He does his patented flip the glove and shoot it like he's duck hunting. One of these times he's going to get clobbered for that. But yeah, I heard they added new celebrations, like something like a dozen new celebrations into the game. So next time out, or one of the next times out here, I'm going to have to go in and check that out and see if we can equip another new fun one. But for right now, you see he's there to collect the garbage and get quite an easy goal, just driving to the net and rewarded for that. It is 2-1 Columbus. Here's a slap shot that's going to miss wide and working to keep this puck in. Forecheck still working. Cycling around. This is going to be out to the point. And that's wide into the corner. Courtnall going to try to get possession. They're still fighting for it. He comes out front. Passes and sets up his teammate. It's another assist for Courtnall. He's got two of those to go along with his goal. And once again, it's a 3-1 lead for Columbus. This time it's Boone Jenner who emphatically slams this one home as you see the nice backhanded pass right on to the one-timer from Boone Jenner as you see him setting up right there and beating Layton in glove side. And just like they had on the Blackhawks, it's a 3-1 lead. Yeah, what have we said about 3-1 leads this year? A lot of people blowing them. There's a big hit in the corner, and Columbus is going to take exception to that, jumping right in here to come to the teammates' aid, and we've got a fight. Let's see if this fires up both sides here as they are going at it. You see Courtnall kind of tussling here as well. He's not going to drop the gloves, but when this is all said and done, hopefully we've sent a statement that you're not going to run any of our players here and get away with it. There's a win in the fight for Columbus. We're winning the game here as well right now, 3-1. Make that 3-2. Maybe Dallas did get some momentum from that fight as we're right back into this game. One goal lead, jumping over the boards here and trying to get back on defense. This could be worked around by Dallas to the point. Trying to get a block, misses it there. And that's unfortunate because it ends up in the net. Johnny Oduya ties this up. And stop me if you've heard this one before, but we blow a two-goal lead and it is now 3-3. You might as well call us the Golden State Warriors. You might as well call us the Cleveland Indians. We're getting really good at blowing 3-1 leads right now. And that shot is wide behind the net, but look at that for a lucky bounce, if you will, for the Dallas Stars. This one right here caroms right onto the stick, and does he hit this one out of midair? I don't know, but this goal came from kind of a sharp angle, Aster. This goes wide and to the boards. Watch it come. Yeah, he knocks it out of midair. And he's right on the goal line, essentially. That's a very sharp angle to be able to direct that into the net out of midair, but yet somehow he does that. They end up getting an empty netter and winning this thing 5-3. So once again, a two-goal lead, and we cannot hold it. And we drop a hockey game that, well, we had a very real chance to win. So young Russ Courtnall contributing in both these games, but not contributing enough to help his team get the W. Little frustration here to start the season for Columbus as we drop to 1-3 and Dallas celebrates on their home ice. So they sweep the three Stars on the night and they get the victory 5-3. So when we come back, we'll pick up play against the Los Angeles Kings and beyond as we are on a West Coast trip. It'll be LA, San Jose, and Anaheim next time for more Russ Courtnall.